This is the second video in the series where I show how I made games with programming languages that you don't see every day being used to make games. In this case, we will be taking a look at FreeBASIC. Unfortunately for me, I'm not old enough to say I experienced the BASIC language. I think I can say most old school programmers have heard or used BASIC at least once in their lives. It's a neat language to learn the very basics of programming. As it says on the Wikipedia page, BASIC declined in popularity in the 1990s. Nowadays, you may be able to find this language in Visual Basic and VisualBasic.net applications. BASIC has a huge list of different dialects for different platforms, from computers to PLCs and even consoles. Among all of these, I'll be focusing on one called FreeBASIC. FreeBASIC is a multi-platform compiler and programming language based on BASIC. It also provides compatibility with programs written in QuickBASIC, a compiler developed by Microsoft. The amazing thing about this language is its full support for libraries made with the C programming language. This makes things like making a game using an existing C library much easier. I like to think of this language as if BASIC and C had a baby. We would have FreeBASIC. Take a look at this simple code. First, you'll notice that the syntax is very similar to BASIC. There are some features that are the same in C, like the preprocessor directives and conditional compiling, not shown in this test. There's also pointers, macros, object-oriented programming support, procedure overloading, enumerators, and many, many more features. As for why I consider this language unusual, although you may find BASIC used in different fantasy consoles and computers, I believe it pretty much lost popularity in favor of modern programming languages. If you know any companies, group of people or anyone who uses any sort of BASIC dialect, let me know in the comments. Let's take a look at what the game is about. Sometimes I look at Argentina's flag and think, man, that's one goofy sun. Then I look at Uruguay's flag and think the same thing. So what about we put these two suns together and make them fight in a bullet hell-like game? As always, I'm not going to get into much detail. To make this game, I used the bindings of a C library called Raylib. Raylib is, as it says on its website, simple and easy to use library to enjoy video games programming. I actually used it in the past and I feel like is actually higher level than SDL. Especially because it was made for teaching. Like SDL, you'll probably see this library a lot since it's made in the C language. So it has bindings for lots of languages. First there's a main script, which is pretty simple, it's the entry point of the game. It creates a game object, initializes things and runs forever. The game loop is also very simple. It's as follows. The infinite loop, which ends when the user wants to close the window. The update part, where the enemy's logic is updated, read the user's keyboard, update timers, etc. And finally, the drawing part, where we render everything on the screen. The boss in this game is Argentina's sun. First, we have the sun ray, which is just the rays rotating around the sun. Then we have the eyes. I want the sun to follow the player with the eyes to give an intimidating effect. And we also have the sun object. Notice that this is where the different bullets are stored, where max bullets is defined by a preprocessor directive. Also notice how we have a list of waves defined in a different object called boss wave. The boss wave object is just to hold important values, like the region where the sun can randomly move, and different timers. Going back to the boss file, I wanted to show how I was able to define simple code into macros. For example, every time I want to create a new bullet, I have to loop through the list until I found the first and active one. This is a really neat feature. Finally, we have the player object. It's very similar to the boss object, adding the adirectional movement with the keys, shooting with a space key and checking if the game is over. That was a brief overview of how I organized the code of this game. To finish this video, I will show you a simple playthrough. Thank you so much for watching.